Volvo Ocean Race fleet is just days away from the finish of Leg 2, 7,000 nautical miles from Lisbon to Cape Town, South Africa. The race continues to challenge even the most experienced, whilst for those attempting it for the first time, it's highlighted the high degree of competitiveness in the One Design fleet.
It's a new place for the team to be in, right? We're getting our head kicked in, scared out to scared, and not really being able to fix it or not exactly knowing what's wrong. It's quite hard. Bloody hard, this race. And the opposition are bloody good.
Hard to keep your emotions in check, but that's sport, isn't it? If he wasn't emotional, probably wouldn't do it.
After a fast and furious opening 10 days at sea and an unusually rapid passage through the notorious, generally windless doldrums, the fleet are halfway home. For 7 consecutive days, Team Brunel and Vestas 11th Hour Racing were locked in a private race of their own for third, until the Dutch team finally broke the deadlock against the Leg 1 winners, setting their sights on the leaders.
Got to keep pushing. We've got Matt Frey in our sights, and that's our kind of next target. So we've honed in on them like a heat-seeking missile, and we're going to take them down next.
The fleet then had to roll the dice. How to navigate the St. Helena High, a near stationary high-pressure system in the South Atlantic, which blocks the direct route to Cape Town. The lead pack of Dongfeng Race Team, Matt Frey, Team Brunel, and Vestas 11th Hour Racing aimed their bows south and west, closest to the Brazilian coast, working around the centre of the high in a bid to be the first of the fresh westerlies in a rapid ride towards the finish.
There's been a little bit of a high pressure ridge, and it's forcing us a little bit further to the west toward Brazil to get around it. And a little bit of a difference in opinion with Brunel as to what's the best way to do it, so we'll see what happens in a few days.
Team Exxonobel gambled and elected to cut the corner to head east, taking the inside track around the St. Helena High in an effort to overhaul the leading quartet to their southwest.
They are to the east of us, and so you can either continue south as we're doing, and then blast across east with the front a little bit later. Probably in a day or two, but they're saying to cut the corner to try and sail less distance and try to get to Cape Town earlier, but with the risk of missing the good part of the front.
After struggling earlier in the league, Hong Kong's Sung Hung Kai Scallywag fought their way back into the mix, drawing level with Di Cafari's Turn the Tide on Plastic.
I mean, you can see we're 2,500 miles to go, 10 days more sailing, but 11 days into the leg, we're about 200 metres in the lead and they're half a mile away.
I'm pissed. They're still there. I want to get rid of them. Bloody scallies.
A week from the finish, the fleet faced one of the most critical decisions of the leg, a test of nerves for all the navigators, when to turn left towards Cape Town.
Well, we were one of the first ones to jibe actually away from Cape Town. Further to the west, there's more pressure. So we're trying to get to that area and then do the final jibe and come on the train from that way.
After leading for most of the leg, the mood on board Dongfeng Race Team plummeted after delaying their decision to jibe and allowing Mafrey to move first and take over as leaders. As a result, the Chinese flag team found themselves east, closer to the light winds of the high pressure system, and paid the price, battling instead for third.
We are fucked.
Well, the last 24 hours after Santa Helena High, we took the south as far south as possible and the quickest as possible, and right now it's paying quite well to be here south of the fleet, and hopefully we can keep going like this with a little bit more wind than the others and moving forward.
But with nearly a week of sailing still to go, there's plenty of racing left on leg 2 and plenty of time for things to change. With breeze on, Mafre lead the charge as the fleet turn their bows towards Cape Town, expected to arrive over the weekend.